Let's get it.
Good evening. The Soviet Union is no more. Despite a potential for instability and chaos, these events clearly serve our national interest.
Dude.
Specter of global conflict.
Treyarch. I'm so hyped, bro.
Today we celebrate the mystery of American renewal.
Oh my god, bro.
Something's going on. Something big.
Let's go, dude. Dude, I'm so excited to be back with the Black Ops, so, bro. Yes. Damn. I mean, that's real, dude. Don't trust anyone, though. Don't trust anyone. Damn, bro. We're gonna be lit. CIA, that's me, bro. Oh my god. Let's go, dudes. Yes, sir, bro. Yes, sir, bro. Oh, we're ready, bro. Oh, we're ready, brother. Oh, we're ready, brother. Let's go.
Continue to bless the United States of America.
America, bro.
And get the Hunters versus Hunted Operator Pack, the Mastercraft Weapon Collection, the Season 1 Black Cell Bundle, and more.
The Gobble Gums, buddy. The Gobble Gums, dude. Let's go, dude. Gobble Gums are back. Let's get it. Let's go, boys. Oh, yeah, sorry about. Let's go, dude. I'm so excited, dude. Fucking love Black Ops.
Hello, and welcome to Treyarch in Los Angeles, and thanks for joining us today. We're excited to share what we've been working on for the past few years. For Black Ops 6, we really wanted to give ourselves the time to craft something truly great. This means we're delivering a new level of polish and innovation across all parts of the game. I've been working here for over 20 years, and I can tell you that we have something special on our hands with Black Ops 6. And I know that the team are excited to give you a deep dive into our campaign and global innovations across the entire game.
With Black Ops 6, we're taking players to a new but familiar era, the early 90s. In true signature Black Ops fashion, our story builds on real history, thrusting players into a conspiracy where a shadowy force has infiltrated the highest levels of the U.S. government, branding anyone who resists as traitors and forcing players to go
home
for the first time to fight the very machine that created them.
Damn.
The team has been meticulously crafting every aspect of this game to deliver the fun and attitude players expect from the Black Ops franchise.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Multiplayer is of course here and brings the Black Ops style and provides a playground for the brand new Omni movement system. A new way to push beyond your limits.
Omni movement.
Like an action hero. You'll see a sneak peek of that later today.
Interesting.
Ground-based zombies is absolutely back and better than ever.
Let's go. Yes, sir.
Let's step into the mind-bending campaign experience we've been crafting with our partners at Raven.
Dude, let's go.
Every Call of Duty player has a favorite campaign mission.
we set out to make Black Ops 6, we were focused on delivering missions so iconic that they stick in your memory long after. We are bringing that action-packed blockbuster feel to every step of the narrative. We are giving you more variety, more dynamic moment-to-moment gameplay, and more options to finish each mission.
We can do this loud or quiet.
That's nice, bro.
The game is packed with unexpected moments of Black Ops mystery. It's a high-octane spy thriller where you're never sure who to trust and what's real. And it's all set against the backdrop of the early 90s. The Soviet Union was crumbling after the fall of the Berlin Wall and the end of the Cold War. The U.S. is the only remaining superpower. The Gulf War was dominating headlines everywhere. And there was a growing mistrust in government reflected everywhere across the music, television,
damn, bro,
and pop culture of the time.
It's so good.
When we talk about the Black Ops timeline, Black Ops 6 comes after the events of the Cold War, but is directly tied to the 1986 flashbacks in Black Ops 2,
okay,
the aftermath of which has left our heroes in dire circumstances.
Without any of their usual resources, they have to build their own team, recruiting two exciting new characters in Felix Newman, a technical genius, and Sabati Dima, a mysterious assassin.
Nice.
With the end of the Cold War, these former enemies have become new allies. And with the sudden return of notorious operative Russell Adler, who'd gone missing for months, former ally may have become a new enemy.
Dun, dun, dun.
For the Black Ops single-player campaign, we prioritize mission variety and unique experiences. One moment, you'll be storming a palace. The next, you'll be pulling off a heist at a casino.
Fire.
We take players all over the world and immerse them in vastly different experiences. Where we have different combat styles, we also have conversation opportunities where you can talk, barter, and manipulate your way into different experiences. And we think you'll want to replay levels to see them all.
Nice. Dude, that looks fire.
One mission in particular takes place in a vast desert in Iraq. You and your team are hunting down missile launchers with the SAS. It's one of the largest campaign maps that we've ever created.
Damn.
You'll find that some of our destinations have a startling contrast in look and feel as well. We have a mission that takes place in an opulent casino in southern Europe.
That's nice, bro.
It's unlike any past mission in Call of Duty. What
W.
the player does in this space is totally unexpected. And another one of our missions we have set in the harsh tundra of northern Russia.
Nice, dude. Diversity.
We are excited to offer an array of brand new equipment, as well as some favorites from the Black Ops universe. RCXD, tranquilizer.
Let's go, RCXD? Nice, dude.
Adrenaline stim, homing knife.
Oh, shit. We got exploding throwing knives? Damn, bro. That's pretty fire.
With Black Ops 6, our goal is to create a more connected experience that keeps players immersed across every single mode.
That's good.
We've pushed ourselves at every corner to innovate and craft the most signature Black Ops experience for our players.
Okay.
Movement has been a consistent area of focus and innovation for Call of Duty. And with Black Ops 6, we're redefining movement across the entire game. For the first time ever, players can sprint in any direction and move like a true Black Ops action hero with an entirely new global system.
Oh, shit. You can sprint in any direction?
The ability to move like never before and seamlessly chain combat maneuvers like slide.
Oh, shit.
And our enhanced supine prone in full 360 degrees range of motion.
Oh shit, dude.
From the beginning, we started with you can't do this thing, why? And then
fuck, dude, that's actually crazy, bro.
What happens if we get rid of that construct?
Wow.
It opened up like, oh,
nah, that's actually groundbreaking. What? Damn, that's exciting, bro. Holy shit. That's gonna feel different, bro. That's game changing. What? Oh my god. Fuck yeah. No, that's gonna make this feel so smooth.
It's really been something that changes how you think and play the game, whether it's campaign, MP, or zombies.
Holy.
I truly believe experience Omni movement, there's no going back.
Damn, bro. That's game changing. That is game changing. Holy shit, bro. That's actually crazy. No lie.
We also have what we're calling intelligent movement, which is a set of features that drastically reduces how many buttons or keys you're pressing to perform various movements. These can be enabled in player options, broken down into three categories: sprint assist, mantle assist, and crouch assist. And each of these settings will allow for fine tuning.
Just okay.
Movement really started with this idea that we want all players to focus on what they want to do and not how to do.
Automatically doing things for you.
We want every player, regardless of skill level or input or experience with Call of Duty, to be able to engage with Omni movement.
That could be nice.
About their own action hero fantasy in Black Ops 6.
Dude, this is why we stand Treyarch, bro.
Zones are regions on a character that react when taking damage or dying. In past games, we've only had 4 regions. For Black Ops 6, we've actually increased that to 9
regions. Nice, dude. Oh my god, bro. Let's go. That is so much better, bro. It's actually... Let's go, bro. Treyarch. More hitboxes. More accurate hitboxes.
Your weapon's gonna dynamically rotate in the direction that you're rounding that corner.
Okay.
Since it's dynamic, it'll be a bit more dramatic if you're slowly clearing the room, but won't affect you at all if you're barreling full speed around that same corner.
Okay.
We're constantly looking for opportunities to set the bar with movement and animations in Black Ops 6.
Oh, you're doing that in Black Ops 6? Yeah, bro. Nice. Let's go.
They're procuring gear by any means necessary, and it allowed us to pull a unique mix of weapons. We made sure to deliver dozens of unique attachments for every gun, and this allows players to create a weapon to match any playstyle that you can imagine, all while maintaining the feel and tone of the era.
That's so.
The Black Ops 6 user experience is all about focusing players on what they need when they need. And our in-game HUD is no different. From the mini-map to the ammo widget to in-game notifications, the Black Ops 6 HUD combines some of our best designs in a clean, streamlined experience. For the first time in Call of Duty, players will be able to change their HUD in dramatic ways to suit their needs. For instance, streamers can choose a layout optimized for their setup, or maybe you want your HUD centered so you don't have to look away.
That's wild.
Or anywhere, or finally put the mini-map in the bottom left, those are options as well.
Dude, that's crazy.
Not only does the HUD give players important status, connects them to the world, and helps them feel rewarded for being awesome.
As players, that's gonna be so nice for streamers, for real.
Their next level unlock, Black Ops 6 delivers an end-to-end experience from the lobby into combat and back, where player progress and achievement are celebrated in a big way.
Nice.
Early on in Black Ops 6's development, we set a goal to make leveling and XP matter more than ever. Looking back through the Call of Duty and Black Ops catalog, there's a lot of love, both internally at Treyarch and that we see in our community, for how we used to handle prestige.
Yes, dude. Thank you.
Traditional prestige is back.
Dude! No!
Let's go.
Yes, sir.
Woo! Max player level will have the choice to enter prestige, start fresh with relocked gear, and
nice. Let's go, dude.
We'll have 10 prestiges, each with a valuable set of rewards to earn and equip to peacock your status. Players who make it through prestige 10 aren't done. Instead, they'll graduate into Prestige Master with 1,000 additional levels to climb through.
And a yes, sir.
Reward to uncover for anyone dedicated enough to make it all the way to the end.
Yes, sir.
Prestige system is available on day one.
Yes, fucking sir, dude.
Let's go,
dude. We're going off. We're back. We are fucking back. We are back. It's been so long. Since the traditional prestige system.
Our vision since day one has been to craft an approachable and engaging step change of that signature Black Ops multiplayer experience. We focused on supporting three core playstyles for launch. Enforcers are the slayers who like to kill and stay on the move. Recon is all about intel and counter intel play. And strategists are support players who throw their bodies at objectives for the win, or focus on taking out enemy score streaks for the team. All of our weapons, gear, and gadgets in multiplayer have been intentionally designed through that lens of supporting these playstyles.
Interesting.
And of course, it wouldn't be a Black Ops game if you can't relive those action hero moments in theater mode, which we're happy to
oh, nice.
With Black Ops 6.
Let's go, dude.
We're only getting a taste of MP today.
Dude, Treyarch on top. Treyarch on top. Theater mode in the game. Nice.
Which can be played at 66 or 2v2. What do players like? What do we know that they want? So we're back to our classic three lane maps.
Oh my god, dude, this game is perfect.
We have Alice with more medium size, like better for hardcore pacing to keep the action flowing but still have meaningful decisions for the player to make.
Let's go. Makes sense.
We've covered a lot today, but couldn't leave you without giving you just one more thing.
Zombies.
Round-based zombies is back. Picking up the Dark Aether storyline where we left it. We're excited to announce that there will be two brand new maps available at launch, with a curated mix of fan favorite features and new elements to discover.
Nice.
For those new to zombies, it's our unique take on the cooperative horde mode, where every map is packed full of powerful weapons and upgrades, deadly enemies, and tons of secrets to uncover. The legacy of zombies is incredibly important to Treyarch, and we are so proud of what the mode is bringing to players in Black Ops 6. As you've heard today, the innovations in movement systems will also be coming to zombies.
W.
Plus, there are many additional zombie-specific features, both new and returning. This is going to be a truly epic return for round-based zombies.
Nice.
Be on the lookout for more intel coming later this year.
Let's fucking go.
We'll be sharing so much more about Black Ops 6 in the coming months and look forward to seeing your reactions and your feedback from our open beta.
Omni movement seems fire. We got round-based zombies. Three lane maps, bro. This game's gonna go good. I'm so happy, bro.
Am I allowed to talk about Warzone? Yeah.
Our goal on Black Ops 6 was and still is to make something that is the best work we've ever done and frankly the most fun to play. To do that, we deconstructed all of our gameplay, our systems, and content plans and repeatedly asked how something could be better. In some cases, that led us to huge innovations like Omni-Movement, where we're now allowing players to move how real people and operators move. In other cases, it led us back to some of our classic systems like Prestige, then taking that classic system through the ringer and making updates and improvements. Across our weapons, gear, operators, maps, and more, a huge push has been to hit the highest visual and
this game is going to be so good.
The campaign tells an all-new Black Ops story where you're forced to go rogue and are being hunted by the teams that trained you. On top of that, the team is really focused on mission and engagement variety. Multiplayer is a key ingredient in the DNA of Black Ops, and hopefully, in this sneak peek, it was clear that every single part of the MP game loop will be improved and better than ever. equipment,
yeah,
to shooting, to footsteps, to engagement systems, to death. And last but definitely not least, the triumphant return of ground-based zombies.
Yes, sir, bro.
There's so much more to share across.
Dude, I'm so excited for ground-based zombies, bro.
Officially launches on October
20th. Oh my lordy.
On behalf of the entire team, we can't wait for you to play Call of Duty Black Ops 6.
Nice, dude. Let's go. W, bro. W. Round-based zombies, classic prestige, three-lane maps. We are so fucking back, ladies and gentlemen. We are so back. Let's go.
Let's go.
I am so excited, bro. I cannot wait. It has been too long. It's been 4 years. Classic prestige, three lane maps, Treyarch Call of Duty. Honestly, all the HUD customization, that is wild too. I really cannot fucking wait, guys. Let's go. We are in for a good year of Call of Duty. In Treyarch, we fucking trust, bro. Let's go.